Once again, the country is vexed over fatal police shootings of African-American males. The one in Charlotte, North Carolina, police say involved a man in a parking lot with a gun. Family disputed that. Police say no, he had a gun. Put that aside for a minute and focus on Tulsa, Oklahoma, where we had one man clearly unarmed walking into his vehicle, which stalled in the middle of the highway. Now, he had his hands above his head on his way to his vehicle. For all we know, police could have been telling him to stop. They said he wasn't obeying commands. The voices from the cops in the helicopter watching, one cop said, looks like a bad dude, and they may have to taser him. And after he was shot to death by the police woman, the cop in the helicopter said, it looks like he was tasered. Well, no, he wasn't tasered. The police woman who shot him said, it looked like he was reaching in his vehicle. Well, of course, his window was closed. So it just makes you wonder, why in 2016 do we not have the technology to neutralize somebody, especially if they're under the influence of drugs or alcohol? Can't they be neutralized with some sort of tranquilizing device? You talk about tasers or stun guns or whatever it is. We could put people on the moon 40 years ago. Can we not stunt someone without killing them? The terrorist in New Jersey, New York, was shot in the leg. It was a shootout. It just happened to be shot there. But the protesters were saying, how come they didn't kill the terrorists? They killed this guy in Oklahoma and the guy in North Carolina, again, without knowing all the facts. All I know is, should we have a conversation about some way of neutralizing somebody short of killing them? And I don't know the answer. We do have the technology, I'm quite sure. Say, when do you use a taser, or when do you use some other kind of device, technology, I don't know. But it's very sad to see somebody without a gun who's walking to his vehicle where the vehicle is closed and the window is closed be shot to death. We should be vigilant as a country in reaching a consensus on how police should react in these situations to prevent more violence, death, and riots. My 2 cents. My 2 minutes are brought to you by Edge Construction and Capital Consultants. Bill McCushion, a lobbyist who worked for Tommy, who knows how to get things done downtown. We can talk about this and more on the radio tomorrow at 8 on 92.1 FM, The Mic, The Mitch Henck Show. Talk to you then.